Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to paint this garden scene with a gate in the middle and some purple flowers, pink, lots of green. Overall, we're going to be using a lot of color today. I'll have a full list below the video in the description. And I'm going to begin on a 16 by 20 canvas. It's been primed once with white acrylic gesso. I let it dry and the canvas is prepped and ready for the paint now. And I've got a number 50 blending brush, Filbert brush. I'm gonna get wet first and start working on the background. And I'm gonna take some turquoise with some white. And I'm gonna start pulling diagonally. I wanna see hints of this turquoise through the gate. And then we'll add some pretty sun rays, but we need something bright in the background, but dark enough that the sun rays will show up. So add a little bit more of the turquoise here. Okay, and then right away I'm going to take some yellow without washing my brush off. And I'm going to start to scoop down here. This will be our little path, little grassy path leading up to the gate. I'm also going to add some back here just for some light behind some of the foliage we'll be adding. I'm going to add a little bit of green gold before I add my purple flowers. Just adding a little bit of water to my brush just to help blend that out a little bit more. I've got a large mop brush here that I'm going to be using, and I'm just going to take some of my green gold and I'm going to tap in. The brush is dry, I didn't get any water on it, and I'm going to start tapping lightly in here and then kind of pulling and dragging for some little shadows or darker mossy areas here. Now I'm going to add a little tiny bit of water on my brush, and that's just going to help loosen up the remainder of the paint and help me pull and get these long, smooth brush strokes. Okay, so the next thing that I want to do is start painting the gate that we're going to have here. I've got this little round brush here, it's a number 2, and I'm going to use black. A little bit of water on my brush. So I'm just going to do like a half moon and go across. Down the center. And see how I'm pulling in? So I start here, pull in, meet it down towards here, coming from the other side. And then I like to make these ornate wrought iron designs. I think it's fun just to play around and do something neat like this. Just have fun experimenting. And whatever you don't like, you can cover up with flowers if you like. Flowers or ferns or vines. where this is mostly going to be covered up, but it's just kind of fun to play around and make it as ornate as you want or like. I'm just going to add a black line down here for the base of the gate, and we're going to kind of cover this up with some flowers and some green foliage. Take one of my oval mop brushes now. This is a 1 inch, and a little bit of yellow, a little bit of black, and I'm going to make green. It's very similar to that green gold. And I'm just going to start tapping at the base here and then start to turn my brush on an angle so we get that feeling that it's starting to kind of grow and curve up. I want this to have a lot of old charm, like this is a really old secret garden, long and forgotten. Things are kind of grown over a little bit. Vines are growing in and around the wrought iron gate entrance here. And then I'm going to start tapping up here. And we'll just add some more plants up here before we come in with purple flowers. Kind of create a bit of a vignette, make the outer edges dark, and then we'll have that light beaming through the gate, really drawing our eye into the center. Try to think about what you want your focal point to be. I'm just going to scumble the rest of the paint out down here. And then I'm just going to keep tapping. And I'm just gonna keep building this up. And a little bit of water on my brush now. Turn my brush sideways like this. Lightly pull and flick. And scumble a little bit of this down here. Create a little bit more of a shadow down here on the path. Okay, with that same brush, I'm going to take a bit of white and yellow. And I'm just going to tap some highlights on here. Okay, so I'm going to start with a little bit of this phthalo blue, and I'm going to overlap right onto this black and yellow. You can do two things to apply this. You can tap it on, and then in some areas, you can just blend it on there or scumble. This is going to give us different tones and hues of greens and a little bit of blue in here. I'm going to apply a little bit more blue, a little bit heavier here. Then after, when I come in with some of that pink and rose over top of the blue, it'll make a really pretty purple color. Okay, now I'm going to take my number 30 Filbert brush, and I'm just going to pick up a little bit of white with a bit of that blue and a little bit of my light ultramarine blue. And I'm just going to start kind of swirling in and tapping to get some soft tones in here before I come in with some darker colors. And to give it sort of a mistiness to it, maybe it's the morning, beautiful morning fog. Not everywhere, we just want to add it a little bit here and there. Okay, now I'm gonna go into this blue. full strength. It's a light blue violet, or light ultramarine blue, same thing. I'm gonna turn my brush this way, and I'm just gonna start tapping. And kind of travel with my brush over here and bring these purple, I guess they look like wisteria. It can be wisteria. And wisteria kind of grows, wraps itself around whatever it can. So we'll have it up here. See how pretty it looks with that little bit of mist back there? Now we're going to make a pretty color by taking some rose and that blue and a little bit of phthalo. This is going to create some shadows and add another pretty color to these flowers. Okay, the next brush I'm going to use is a small mop brush, and I'm just going to take a little bit of white this time with those colors, a little bit more white. Take a little bit of pink with my white. And just add a little bit. A few little taps and pulls in here. Okay, now I'm going to start coming in the foreground and making a few little flowers, a little bit of pink. Maybe we've got some stalks, phlox or lupin or delphinium. I'll add a little bit of white, a bit of a highlight. Well, let's add a little bit of yellow and white. And then just sweep those colors gently out onto the path. Let's add a little bit more pink and white. Get a nice, soft, delicate touch of that pink. Okay, I'm going to come back in with my large stipple mop type of brush, and I'm going to take my pink and whatever luminous rose I've got left there, and I'll just start tapping in. Right here and along this edge. So I'm going to overlap see whatever color that I'm painting over, it changes the tone up a little bit. I'm going to take some white now. And I'll start at the top. And just add some highlights here, take some softer tones. Doing lots of little taps here just to get the illusion of little lupins or foxgloves. And I can switch over to a smaller brush as well to define those just a little bit more. Take a little bit more white here. Right away, I'm going to go into my phthalo pink and that light blue again. I want everything to sort of flow together. So as it comes down, it's kind of going around. Okay, now right under here, I'm gonna add a little bit of a shadow. So you could take green gold, but I've got a little bit of black in my lemon yellow here so I can get that sort of color. And just really lightly and carefully I can go, you can go over partially. Just lightly pull in there, and then I'll take a little bit more and I'll just tap in. A little bit like this. And then I'll go into my blue, and maybe add some bright blue stalks here. Take a little bit of turquoise in there too, that would look pretty. A little bit of white. And then a little bit of phthalo black at the bottom just for some shadow. Bit of yellow. For the suggestion of some leaves here. And I'm going to take a little bit more of my pink now. Overlap. A little bit of white. Now I'm going to take a little bit of white with my yellow for the top of the stalk. And I'll go back to some white. I need a little bit more white here. highlight some of these, make these little flower buds or petals stand out some more. Take a combination of yellow and white now and put a little something right here. Okay, now I want to add a highlight in here, and I'm going to use, I haven't really used my orange very much here at all, have I? A little bit of neon yellow first, the warm, and we'll just add, start to add in some warm bits of light in here. I'll even add a little bit here. It looks really pretty, this color with the light lavender and violet. And that blue. Take a little bit of the neon orange, which is a really pretty, pretty color to add here. And take a bit of the orange with the pink. And a little bit over here as well. And a little bit of turquoise. Sometimes you get those cool shadows. Have a hint of a bluey. Right, a cool shadow is going to be more on the cool side, right? The blue. Okay, so for our sun rays, I'm going to be using this number 10 flat brush. I'm going to get a bit of water on my brush, and I'm going to take some white. I'm going to take a little bit of that warm yellow. The trick is to have just the right amount of water on your brush, but not so much that you make a big mess, right? You want it to be transparent. So we're going to start from this side, see how we did the turquoise in the background diagonally like that. We can have some peeking in through here. And of course, some from behind. And if you find it difficult, sometimes it's easier just to go right over it and then go back in with black over top. And it's up to you how much you want to add. I think I want to bring mine out here a little bit further. I'm just going to create a little bit of mist down here. In there. Okay guys, so I'm gonna paint some butterflies now, some monarch butterflies, and I'm gonna be using a Filbert brush. Use any Filbert brush that you want. I'm gonna start with a little bit of white and my light yellow warm. So you really want to have a white base first to start with. So I'll add another one right here, and they're going to get a little bit smaller. So I'm going to make this one a little bit bigger. I'm gonna add another one here that's really small. And then some little baby ones here that end up just looking like they're fading off and we can't even see any details on them. The Filbert brush is really handy for not only flower petals, but butterfly wings, dragonfly wings too. Okay, so it's dry now and I'm gonna take my neon orange and my neon yellow warm. I'm gonna make it look a little patchy on purpose like this, because if you look at the butterflies, they're not the same orange all over. Some areas are lighter, darker, brighter. Getting a little bit of water on my brush, twisting and rolling, working the paint to more of the tip of the brush where I want to use it. Work on the body here, a little bit wider there. Then we're going to go up, push, wiggle, and around. We have that sort of scalloped shape to them. And I'll just continue with the rest of the butterflies the same way. If I'm careful, I can continue just using this brush for the other butterflies. Just use the very tip of my brush. Switch over to my number one liner brush, get a bit of water, a little bit of black, and I'll just start creating my pattern. Okay, now I'm going to take white with a clean brush, and I'm going to start adding the little white dots. And they start to get a little bit smaller. Okay, everybody, so I hope you enjoyed this painting today and you want to paint along with me. Don't forget to subscribe for more, leave a comment below, and like this video. I'll see you all soon next time. Bye!